Imagine, you're an aspiring software developer and your local pizza restaurant contacts you to make an online pizza ordering platform. You start programming right away and after a few weeks of hard work, the website is ready for people to use. Shortly after, you start receiving complaints from the restaurant that people do not understand how the site works and bugs keep appearing. The question now is, what happened? Many things could have gone wrong. You did not think out the idea well enough, you did not spend enough time on the implementation, or you did not test it well enough. But all of these possible problems derive from something you completely forgot to do: task modeling. Hello, my name is Maxim from Wynckel, and in this video I will explain you how you can do task modeling with CTTs or concurrent task trees and how it benefits in your software implementation. CTTs use a graphical notation to model the hierarchy and relationship between tasks. The hierarchy indicates how a task is subdivided into two or more subtasks, while the relationship indicates the temporal relation between tasks. There are four different types of tasks: interaction tasks that show a user interaction with your system, such as selecting a pizza or entering an address; application tasks that are used to show an action performed by your system, like displaying the price of your order or processing it; user tasks that are basically the same as application tasks, but instead of your system, it involves real humans inside your system. On an online pizza ordering platform, these types of tasks are fairly limited, but it could be used to show tasks where you have to wait for your order to be accepted by the restaurant, for example. And lastly, an abstract task that shows a task that is or can be subdivided into a combination of all of these four tasks. There are 9 different types of temporal relationships between tasks. They are visualized by a line with a symbol in between. One of these relationships are disabling tasks. Continue with our online pizza ordering platform that we were asked to make. We basically want to create a system where we can order pizza. Once we confirm the order, we have to create a new order if we were to order something again. The disabling relation indicates that once we confirm the order, all tasks on the left of this confirmation are no longer accessible. But what if we want to order multiple pizzas, or different types of pizzas? First off, we change the task select pizza to the task add to basket. This task is subdivided in selecting a pizza and then specifying the amount you want to add to the basket. This newly introduced relationship is called enabling tasks, because we can only specify an amount once we selected something. In general, the enabling relation between tasks indicates the order in which tasks should be executed. Because we can add multiple different types of pizzas, the add to basket task has an asterisk at the end. This indicates a repeating task or recursion. The rest of the model remains the same as before. In our previous models, we showed that the user could confirm the order, but nothing happened with it. Our platform needs to be able to process this order and save it to a database, for example. We introduce a new application task because it's something that our application needs to do. Once we confirm the order, that very same order gets processed. This new relationship is called enabling with information passing. It is basically the same as the enabling relation used to specify the amount of pizzas you want to order, but it sends information alongside, in this case the order we just made. Because our model no longer contains just user interactions, the root task of making an order has been changed to an abstract task, because it contains both interaction and implication tasks. The pizza restaurant now has a database that shows all the orders that have been made, but it does not show any addresses and the users did not pay for the orders. These are the types of scenarios where task modeling can help you. Maybe forgetting to add an address is not something that will happen, but thinking about it beforehand helps you implement tasks that you may have forgotten otherwise. When we confirm our order, we need to do 2 things. We need to enter our address and then pay for our order. Zooming in on our confirm order task, we added 3 subtasks, one where we enter the address, one where we pay for the order, and lastly one where the payment gets validated. Once the payment is validated, you can't pay again. Well, it would be nice for the restaurants if they can receive double payments, but your users won't really like it that much. The restaurant owner accepts 2 types of payments, via PayPal or credit card. These 2 payment methods are shown with a choice relationship in between. This relationship indicates a choice where all other choices get disabled once you pick one. It is also possible to indicate a task being optional. other than a choice relationship, this does not disable another task and can be skipped. If we were to allow for an additional topping on our delicious pizza, we can put this task optional for those who want to. Placing the optional addition of topping before the task where we specify the order amount indicates that this order amount is for the pizza with the topping. So if I want two margarita pizzas with extra cheese, I only have to select this topping once and select that I want two of these pizzas. We've seen task relationships that indicate a choice or sequence in some way. It is possible to indicate how a task can be run simultaneous or in any particular order. This relationship is called concurrent tasks and can be used in our example to show that you can enter the address and name of your order details in any order. Now that we can add pizzas to our basket, it would be nice to get some indication of how much we will need to pay before we actually confirm our order. A new application task is introduced that displays the order price on the screen. This task has a concurrent communicating relationship between add to basket and this newly created application task. This means that during when we are adding new pizzas to the basket, the price displayed on the page can update simultaneously using information provided by the add to basket task. In this case, this information is the price of all the pizzas combined. We've seen concurrent relationships that showed that you could perform two or more tasks in any order or even switch between them. And while you can do both tasks somewhat parallel by continuously switching between them, it is not true parallel. For this, we have a separated parallel relationship. It allows two or more tasks to be run simultaneously. Examples include multiple actors, such as multiple users or multiple cores in an application. We use the parallel relationship in our order processing task that will save the order to the database and notify the restaurant without having to wait for it to be saved first. There are a few things still missing. For example, we can add pizzas to our basket, but we can't remove them. If we look at an existing online pizza ordering platform like takeaway.com, we can clearly see our add to basket task visualized as the blue button with the plus sign on, and our display order price task as the current price on the top of the screen. To remove something that we added to our basket, e-commerce sites like this one require you to click on the basket icon first. We're going to call this task manage basket. It is part of making an order and can be done at any time during the selecting and adding of pizzas. We use a new relationship called Suspend-resume. It looks very similar as the disabling task symbol, but with a straight vertical line rather than a square bracket. It can be used for interruptible tasks. When you're finished with managing our basket, we can just continue adding new pizzas. Both the manage basket and add to basket task influence the price that is displayed. Due to the priority from left to right used in CTTs, we can just move everything to the right so that the manage basket task has a concurrent communicating relationship with the display order price task. You can assume that both add to basket and manage basket are in concurrent communicating relationship with the display order price task. With the choice relationship, you can choose one option, but all other options get disabled. If we want to extend our manage basket task to include the deletion or change of pizzas inside this basket, we have the choice between a delete pizza task and the change amount task. Managing a basket allows you to do both tasks before the manage basket task is actually completed. So it can be a choice relationship, because that would mean the other choice get disabled. It could be a concurrent relation, but since this relation allows you to switch between the two tasks, it would mean that you can start the change amount task, select the pizza, delete that very same pizza from the basket because you switch over to the delete pizza task, and then continue with changing the amount of the already deleted pizza. This is not possible because you already deleted it. The task independence or order independence relation can help with this. It is similar as a choice relation, with the only exception that it does not disable the other choices, and that the task need to be executed incomplete before it can make a new choice. Because it's specifically meant to indicate two or more tasks that have to be completed, it usually concerns larger tasks that cannot be interrupted. So, how is all of this helpful to you? Well, it can help you to create user interfaces or provide documentation to your colleagues. It's a modeling tool. It's a tool for your brain that helps you think about the project before you rush into it. By learning and improving the syntax of your CTT, you not only improve on the correctness of the CTT, but it makes you aware of the possible problems that you may have missed if you would just start to write code. Creating CTTs is not easy. Many relationships do similar things, and some tasks may be able to have a variety of different relationships between them. But when you see these problems in your task model, it makes you think about, how am I going to implement this? And that is exactly the thing you should do before you start a project. In a sense, task modeling is a way for you to realize what the difficult aspects of your project are. So next time your local pizza restaurant asks you to create an ordering platform, consider modeling the task before you start programming.